In this video, I'm going to focus on designing a snooping-based protocol, and you know this will be implemented on the multiprocessor model that I described earlier, the symmetric multiprocessor, where you'll see that there is a centralized shared memory that everyone has access to, and each processor has its own private cache. Okay, and these private caches and the centralized memory are all connected through this bus. Okay, so anytime I have a miss in my cache, I'm going to place my request on the bus and everyone is going to see it. Okay, and you know this is defined as a snooping based protocol because I'm not going to have a centralized agent that tells everybody what to do. Okay, everyone is going to snoop on the bus and they're all going to be self-managing, that is, they're all going to manage their own cache states. Okay, and you know this will be made clear as I go through some examples. Okay, so let's start with an example. Let's assume that you've just booted up your system and you've initialized a bunch of values. Let's assume that the caches are empty for now. Okay, so there's a block A that is sitting in main memory. Okay, and you know there are processors P1, P2, P3, and P4. Let's say that P1 is first trying to do a read of A. Okay, so now when I do a read of A, I'm going to look up my caches first, and I'm going to discover that I don't have a copy of A in my cache. So I'm going to place a request over here saying I'm trying to do a read of A. Okay, so this request gets placed on the bus and everyone is going to see it. Okay, so all the processors P2, P3, P4 are going to see it. Main memory is also going to see it. Okay, and now they all have to have a certain operation that they have to perform. So P2, P3, and P4 are all going to look up their own caches to see, you know, do I have a copy of A that I could perhaps provide? Okay, and they look up the caches, they all say that, you know, I don't have a copy of A. So they put a signal on this bus saying that, you know, we really don't have a copy of A and, you know, we can't provide A to P1. Okay, so main memory is also going to see that, you know, P1 has made a request. It's also going to see that P2, P3, and P4 are unable to provide a copy of A. So now the onus falls on main memory to provide that copy of A. Okay, so main memory is going to read out A and it's going to place this piece of data on what is called the response bus. Okay, so this bus is made up of a request bus where you place the address and where you place you know the kind of request that you're trying to do, either a read or a write and so on. And then there is a response bus which carries the data block itself. Okay, and then there are also a few other control signals, such as the signal that, you know, P2, P3, and P4 provided to say that they don't have a copy of A and, you know, main memory has to provide that copy of A. Okay, so this bus has a few different components to it. So once the response is placed, everyone sees it. In this case, P1 is going to take that copy of A and then place it in its own cache, right? So there's a copy of A now sitting here. And this block is going to be placed in shared state. And this refers to the fact that, you know, P1 now has permissions to, you know, read this data. And it also refers to the fact that, you know, this copy of A agrees with the copy of A sitting in main memory. Okay, so that's what the shared state means. Then later, let's say that, you know, P4 comes along and does a read of A. It has a miss in its cache, and so, you know, like P1 before, it places a request on the bus saying I'm trying to read A, and everyone sees this request, and everyone checks their cache to see, you know, do I have a copy of A that I can provide to P4. In this case, P2 and P3 say that they don't have a copy, but P1 does have a copy of A. Okay, and you know, since this is a valid copy of A, it can actually provide the data. Okay, and we've seen before that it's much faster to access a cache than it is to access main memory. Okay, so if you cared about performance, we should really tell, you know, P1's cache to now place the copy of A on the response bus, because that would be faster than having to read the value from main memory and then placing it on the bus. Okay, but you know, for now, I'm going to try and keep my protocol as simple as possible. Okay, you know, these are fairly complex protocols to design and build. Okay, so at first, instead of focusing on performance, I'm just going to try and get a correct working protocol in shape. Okay, so for now, you know, since the block is in shared state, I know that, you know, this copy agrees with the copy of A in main memory. So I'm just going to let main memory provide the data. Okay, so if it's in shared state, you know, I'll myself put out the signal saying that I'm not going to provide data, I'm going to leave it up to main memory. Okay, so main memory looks at all the responses from P1, P2, P3, and it says that, you know, no one else is stepping up to provide the data, so I'm going to provide the data. Okay, so this is not the best in terms of performance, but it helps us build a correct protocol, you know, as easily as possible. Okay, so A puts the response back again on the response bus, and P4 picks up that value from the response bus, puts it over here. This is also in shared state because I now have read permissions for this block, and this value of A agrees with the value of A sitting in main memory. Okay, next, you know, let's say that P3 comes along and tries to do a write of A. Okay, so when it tries to write A, it first looks at its cache, realizes that it doesn't have a copy. So it now places a request on the bus saying that I need a copy of A, and I'm trying to do a write into A. Okay, so now everyone is going to see this, right? And like before, since P1 and P4 have a copy in shared state, you know, they say that we are not going to provide the data, we will leave it up to main memory. Okay, so main memory is going to, you know, get the value of A, put it on the bus, and P3 is going to accept the copy of A. Okay, and since it's trying to do a write, we know that this block is soon going to deviate from the copy in main memory. Okay, and so this is not a copy in shared state. This is a block in a state called M, or modified. That is, you know, in the near future, this value is going to change, and it is going to be different from the value in main memory. And that is what the M state reflects. Okay, now when I'm making a change to this cache copy of A, you know, this copy is also going to differ from the other cache copies in P1 and P4, and I should not allow that. Okay, so before I can proceed with making this block in modified state, I have to also invalidate the cache copies in P1 and P4. Okay, so when P1 and P4 were doing the snoop, they should realize that, you know, this is not just an ordinary request for A. This is a request for A, and the request is for a write. Okay, so essentially, I need to make sure that P3 has an exclusive cache copy of A, which means I need to give up my cached copy. Okay, so these blocks move from shared state to invalid state. Okay, so P1 and P4 are relinquishing their cached copies, which allows P3 to have the only exclusive copy, the only exclusive cached copy of A, which means it now has permission to do, you know, all kinds of changes to A. Okay, so it can subsequently do a read of A, it can do, you know, more writes of A, and so on. So having a block in modified state means, you know, I can do whatever I want with this block, and I don't have to inform everybody else of these changes because I know that I have the only cached copy. Okay, and, you know, yes, this copy disagrees with the copy in main memory, but eventually when the block is evicted, I'll update main memory. Okay, so this is a write back policy. We're not using a write through cache. Okay, so now, you know, later, you know, P1 comes along and wants to do a read of A as well. Okay, it looks at its cache and it realizes that it doesn't have a valid cached copy because this block is an invalid state. So, you know, like before, it places a read request on the bus. Okay, and everyone's going to snoop. Okay, and P3 is going to realize that, yes, I do have a cached copy. This is in modified state, which means I have the only valid cached copy. Okay, so I can't put the onus on the main memory to provide data. I am the one that has to respond. Okay, so it places a signal saying, you know, main memory, don't bother. I'm going to provide the data, and here it is. So it reads the value and puts it on the response bus, and P1 picks up the copy of A, and it places the block in shared state, because all P1 is trying to do is read the block, right? So it doesn't need write permissions, and so, you know, having it in shared state is enough. And similarly, you know, P3 now has to relinquish its exclusive control of the block, right? Because now other people also have cache copies, so it downgrades from modified to shared state, saying that, you know, from now on, I don't have permissions to write into this block. I can only read from this block if I need to. And if I do want to write into this block later, then I have to again upgrade my permissions and go back to being in modified state. Okay, but for now, I'm just going to come down to being in shared state. Okay, there's one other implication of a block being in shared state. We said that if a block is in shared state, then this block is consistent with the value of the block in main memory. And, you know, and this is why we were able to let main memory respond to subsequent requests for A. Okay, so this means that anytime I move from modified to shared, this is also the point where I have to update my main memory copy. Okay, because from now on, you know, main memory is going to respond to subsequent requests for A, so it better have the latest and greatest value of A. Okay, so at this point, it's not just P1 that accepts the value of A on the response bus and puts it in its cache. Even main memory has to read the value on the response bus, and it has to perform the write back and update the value of A. Okay, so now, you know, later if P4 were to read A, it gets a valid cache copy. And it's main memory that provides this cache copy.